Hi, my name is Alexi Kenny. I'm very excited to be bringing you this program of works that traverses the entire span of the solo violin repertoire with a couple nuggets of violin with added electronic sounds in there. So I hope you'll enjoy joining me on this journey from pre-Bach all the way to the present day. I'm going to play for you two Allemands. One is by Bach from the D minor Partita, and one is by Paul Wianco from his X suite for solo violin. The reason for the back-to-back is actually that Paul Wianco's piece is inspired by Bach Allemands and by the Allemand dance form, although putting them back-to-back, you might never expect it. Wianco's piece is incredibly extroverted and spirited, at times crazed, while the Bach is expansive and beautiful. But I think providing the contrast will be very interesting. The next two pieces go together as a set, although they weren't intended that way. Enescu's Ménétrier from Impression d'Enfance is a 25-minute work for violin and piano, the first movement of which is for solo violin. It's very evocative of this sort of lonely fiddler sitting on a mountaintop. It's incredibly nostalgic, and I think it really speaks to Enescu's Romanian heritage. The piece goes back to back with Duyun's Udata, which is, you'll hear a background track of chanting monks. The violin essentially undergoes this long journey of an improvisation on top of that. And to me, pairing these two pieces, while the Duyun is incredibly intense and you'll hear wailing and sound effects and intentional out-of-tune notes on the violin, the pairing is really striking to me as they're both somewhat lonely improvisational songs. Thank you. The Colombi Chacona is actually something that was written for viola d'amore, which has many, many more strings than the violin and is usually tuned in the key that that the piece is being played for. So it'll be retuned for every piece. This particular one happens to be in G major, which works very well with the violin. And the transcription that you're about to hear is one that I did myself. This piece is written way before Bach. It is just a beautiful, beautiful cycling chaconne. That will go straight into another movement from Paul Wianco's X Suite for Solo Violin, the Nocturne movement. Starts out incredibly peacefully and sort of rollicks its way to daybreak. So I hope you enjoy these next two pieces.
Thank you.
Nico Muhly's A Long Line utilizes more electronic sounds. This time it's actually a conducted orchestra with added electronic noises in there. So you're going to hear a string section, you're going to hear some woodwinds and brass, but you're also going to hear more sort of synthesizer type sounds alongside the violin. It's actually heavily notated so that each event corresponds in the music with something that I'm doing. It's a really fascinating, beautiful, rhapsodic and melodic piece. Bieber's Passacaglia is perhaps the most major solo violin work written before Bach. It is the last of his mystery sonatas, each of which uses a different tuning on the violin. However, the last one he kept open to the normal violin tuning that we all know today. This piece is incredibly melancholic, but I think is almost a stream of consciousness in that the ground bass never changes, but there's so much variation, so much nuance, so much activity going on top. It's really such a joy for me to get lost in this piece. I've always had a thing about getting into the zone, and I think a lot of artists will talk about that as a place that they want to get to in performance. And for me, it's completely indescribable. I would say only that when I know when I'm in the zone, I know that I'm doing something right. You know, it's that I've forgotten about any pressures, any expectations. It's just kind of this direct link to the music and direct link of my expression coming out of the violin that I think is, crucial. When it happens, it's such a beautiful thing. It's all psychological. I think playing the violin for me is completely psychological activity. And it's all about getting in the right headspace. And if you somehow are able to clear the mind through, concentrating on the things that you need to concentrate on, that you're always thinking about emotion first and always thinking about just true, pure expression. There's a lot of different influences, I think. Even every day walking on the street, I find architecture inspiring. I find people in New York City inspiring, it's just kind of a constant way of being.